we'll see about the cloud security. So we are speaking security is the major concern for anything. Why? Because the data is stored in the remote location. Huge amounts of data or data can be stored in remote location. Some security measures must be taken. So cloud's main responsibility is to be provided the security for the data and for the resources that were provided. So what are the, before the going to that security, we'll see what are the different types of risks that occurs while using the cloud. So cloud computing provides various advantages such as improved collaboration, excellent accessibility, mobility, storage capacity, etc. But at the same time, there are also risks, security risks in the cloud computing. So some of the risks we have like data loss. One of the things is the data loss. In a cloud computing environment, data loss occurs. When our sensitive data is somebody else's hands, so one or more data elements cannot be utilized by the data owner. So hard disk is not working properly and the software is not updated. So these the type of things leads to data loss. Second one is the hacked interfaces or insecure APIs, application program interfaces. So as we all know, cloud computing is completely depends on the internet. So it is compulsory to protect the interfaces and APIs that are used by external users. So APIs are the easiest way to communicate with most of the cloud services. Another cloud computing risk is data breach. Data breach is one process in which the confidential data is by third party people. And the data can be accessed or stolen by the other people without any authorization. So organization data is hacked by the hackers. Another risk by using this cloud is vendor locking. So vendor locking is the biggest security risk in the cloud computing. So organizations may face problems when transferring their services from one vendor to another. So as different vendors provide different platforms, that can cause difficulty moving from one cloud to another. So this leads to third party to hack and stole the data. And these type of risks are known as vendor locking risks. Another type of risk is DOS, known as denial of service or DOS attacks. So DOS attacks occur when the system receives too much traffic to buffer the server. So mostly DOS attackers target web servers in large organizations such as banking sectors, media companies and government organizations. Next, another risk problem is account hijacking. Account hijacking is a serious security risk in cloud computing. So it is the process in which individual users or organizations cloud account, for example, bank account, email account, or social media account. So these things are stolen by the hackers. So the hackers use the stolen account to perform unauthorized activities. So the main goal of the security systems. So what is the main goal to provide the security system? There are several goals of security system. So some of them we'll see now, like integrity, secrecy, availability, etc. So integrity means like unauthorized users must not be allowed to access the system's objects, and users with insufficient rights should not modify the system's critical files and resources. And another goal is secrecy. The system's objects must only be available to a small number of authorized users. The system files should not be accessible to anyone or everyone. Availability is another main goal. All systems and resources must be accessible to all authorized users, but not to unauthorized users. That is, no single user or process should be able to consume all system resources at a time. If such a situation arises, service is denied by occur. So these are the various goals of, to, for providing the security to the cloud system. Some of the threats we can see, those types of threats. We have program threats, system threats. We have. So what are the program threats and system? The program threats means like the operating system's processes and the kernel carry out the specified task as directed. Program threats occur when a user program causes these processes to do malicious operations. The common example of program threat is that when a program is installed on a computer, it could store and transfer user credentials to another. Second one, system threats. System threats are described as the misuse of system services and network connections to cause user problems. These threats may be used to trigger the program threats over an entire network, known as program attacks. System threats make an environment in which OS resources and user files may be misused. So threats to operating system. So there are various threats that cause to the operating system to malfunction. Some of them like malware, network intrusion, etc. So malware means it contains viruses, worms, Trojan horses, and other dangerous software. So these are generally short code that may corrupt files that are stored in your system, delete the data, replicate the data, and even crash the system, crash the total system. Next, network intrusion. So network intruders are classified as two types, masqueraders and misfacers, and another unauthorized users. So masquerader is an unauthorized person who gains access to a system and uses an unauthorized person's account. And a misfacer is a user who gains unauthorized access to and misuse programs, data, and resources. And another one is a buffer overflow. So it is also known as a buffer overrun. So it is the most common and dangerous security issue of the operating system. It is defined as condition at an interface under which more input may be placed into a buffer and a data holding area than the allotted capacity, and it may overwrite other information, etc. So here attackers uses such a situation to theft the data or to crash a system or insert a specially created malware that allows them to take control of the other systems. So how to protect from these attacks? So that is how to ensure operating system security. There are various ways to ensure operating system security. Authentication, one of the things is authentication. So the process of identifying every system user and associating the programs executing with those users is known as authentication. So the operating system is responsible for implementing a security system that ensures the authenticity of a user who is executing a specific program, etc. Another way of providing security to the operating system is by using one-time passwords. Along with the standard authentication, one-time passwords can be given an extra layer of security. So every time a user attempts to log in into the one-time password system, a unique password is needed. Once a one-time password has been used, it can be reused. Another way to provide the security for the operating system is by using firewalls. So firewalls are essential for monitoring all incoming and outgoing traffic. So it imposes local security, defining the traffic that may travel through it. So firewalls are an efficient way of protecting network systems or local systems from any network-based security. Another way is a physical security. So this most important method of maintaining operating system security is physical security. So an attacker with a physical access to a system may edit or remove or steal important files since operating system code and configuration files are stored on the hard disk. So hardware operating system security policies and procedures. So operating system protects systems and data from worms, malware, threats, RAM, ransomware, backdoor intrusions, viruses, etc. So some security policies handle all these things and procedures to ensure an operating system's protection, including edited and deleted data. So as operating system policies and procedures cover larger, there are various techniques to addressing them. Some of them are like installing and updating antivirus software, frequently installing and updating antivirus software, ensure the systems are patched or updated regularly, implementing users management policies to protect user accounts and privileges, installing a firewall and ensuring that it is properly set to monitor all the incoming and outgoing traffic.